Okay.
Yeah, go ahead, be a meme. They gonna forget about you. Yeah, I'm the real King Yi. But like I said, there was a few times where he kind of was talking his stuff and you thought he was talking about somebody specifically.
Yo, this do sound like Yi a little though, to be honest.
There's been a lot of controversy when it comes.
Yo, this do sound like Yi a little though, to be honest.
There's been a lot of controversy when it comes to Ian and Yi fans. Because y'all seen in my last video that Ian had previewed a snippet where he was somewhat taking that 2093 sound. And when that happened, Yi had posted on his story some laughing emojis and people thought, you know, there's some beef going on. And it only got worse because you later found out that they were both dropping on the same day, October 18th, which is today. And as soon as I got back from my trip, I sat on stream and I listened to both albums. And I ain't gonna lie, it's a lot going on. And there's gonna be a lot I gotta say, a lot of good and a lot of bad. But of course, y'all know I listened to the Yi album first. I'm gonna tell you right now, Yi did a great job. That project was way better than 2093. And here's the smart thing that Yi did, though. He did a mix.
I hate how they're trying to compare both albums already. I would not fucking Ian and Yi, but I hate how they're trying to compare both of Yi's albums already. Like, bro, 2093 was equally as good, bro. Like, it was equally. I'm still gonna listen to 2093 this fucking year, like, before the year's over. You know what I mean?
Sound. He didn't just fully scratch the sound that he had for his last project. He kept that sound, added his 2021 sound, but you could just tell it still had that 2093 vibe to it because there were songs in there that were so cinematic, you could put them in movies. But most of the songs still had hype to it. It still had energy, the energy that we were looking for. If you was looking for that 2021 sound, you got that. If you was looking for that 2093 sound, you still got that too. Now, of course, there's songs on there that I really didn't enjoy. It was only four tracks where I could say that Yi fully missed for me. It was two songs that was just like his last project that I really didn't.
Okay, we get it. All right, bro.
Forever again. Those two songs are just 2093 again, literally. And the other two tracks was the song with Kodak Black. And the only reason I say that's a miss because Kodak did horrible on that song. Of course, I like Kodak, but he just didn't do good on that song at all. And for the last one,
you know, I wasn't gonna say anything, but you know, Kodak. I don't know, Kodak sounded good in the speakers, but just in the headphones, you know, hearing it more, sorry. Dirk said something.
Sorry,
no,
Lifestyle with Lil Durk. I don't know what made him put Lil Durk on. He did not need that.
I don't know either. And I think this is officially the fall off of Dirk.
No,
the
Lifestyle.
If this fucking Dirk album is a good, I swear to God, right? It might be up for Dirk. I don't know. And I hate to say that because the other one with Juice on it was a really good album for me. So I would hate to see the downfall of Dirk.
I don't know what made him put Lil Durk on an album. We did not need that. Lil Durk on a Rage 2093 type of beat or Lifestyle. You know, we just didn't need that. But when it came to Yi, he did good on those tracks. But most of the features were horrible, except for Summer and I believe Don Tyler. And it's a lot of songs that stood out to me. For example, like God Talking Shh. Like, that was crazy. And as a whole project, Yi did very well. Especially for a dude that everybody was testing. Everybody wanted to say that Yi fell off and stuff like that. He clearly did. And if he did fall off, he definitely redeemed himself. I don't know what y'all talking about. We can stop putting Yi into that discussion of being stuff, whatever y'all want to call it. I don't know what y'all talking about.
This exactly. I don't want to see Yi in any of the same comments anymore. Just that beginning part. I don't need to read the rest of this. I don't need to see the rest.
We can stop putting Yi into that discussion of being stuff, whatever y'all want to call town. He's not what a. Stop doing that.
I just don't want them in the same combos, period. I wish niggas could just forget about Yi and Ian sounding the fucking same already, and just like, you know what I mean?
On time, that Yi can always go back to his old sound. He's not one of them artists that can just grow out of his old sound and just not go back to it. We didn't heard it with tons of different tracks, even on this album. Anytime you hear them bells or it sound like he off them drugs, the ad-libs are very weird, you know? You can compare songs like that to Up To Me, to Alive. You can go back to that old vibe. He can do it. And there's a lot of artists that can't do that. But Yi did a good thing by like kind of doing a mixture of sound. And now we start with Ian. Now, a lot of people gonna hate me for this, but I'm gonna keep it real. Ian Project overall...
Oh no. Why don't I just get a verification code from on TikTok? Am I about to get hacked? I dead ass got a verification code from on TikTok. Why? Anyway.
Overall, it was just tons of confusion. Now, a lot of people don't hate me for this, but I'm gonna keep it real. Ian Project overall was just tons of confusion. Okay, and the track that stood out the most was definitely Till I Die. And the first song, Showboat, was actually a good song. It wasn't that bad at all. But the other songs on here, I just didn't like. Like, for example, On the Floor, I do not want to hear a twerk song from Ian. I just don't. Maybe it's just not my vibe.
Really,
maybe that's for
a different... really holy twerk. It was just... Okay, so Okay. See, now we're gonna talk about it. Now we are gonna talk about it. So y'all will Portland let any Bain. Other artists, y'all will let any other artist talk about twerking, but as soon as it's Ian, it's just, oh, we don't want to hear that. Like, fuck up. Literally, bro, he literally only says S on the floor in about two verses at least. He says it maybe twice, maybe three times. But if it's anybody else, it's cool. But because it's Yeet, or because it's Ian, y'all are here. Shut up, nigga. Really, bro? Really? It's not even holy. It's not even holy, it's worse.
I don't get it.
Because I fuck with this song a lot. So, he literally only says it twice. Because the fucking... He says here and at the beginning of the song. Twice, bro. Yeah, if you only listen to that part of the song, yeah, he says it. Fucking, he says it, but if you don't listen to that, if you, like, you know, I don't know, bro. Y'all niggas is reaching in the places you don't even need to reach in. It's like, nigga, it's not even really a twerk song. You're not even, he says it twice, bro. I'm not even taking, that fucking opinion, bro.
I just don't. Maybe it's just not my vibe.
I'm not hearing it.
Maybe that's for a different audience. And y'all remember that time where Ian had previewed that snippet of him copying that 2093 sound from Yeet? He actually had like three or four songs like that on the tape, and they all sound like songs that just weren't polished at all. Even if you're not an Ian fan, you could tell that Ian was just trying something new. He thought it was gonna work, and it just didn't for me. Because the Ian that I'm used to is that ATL trap sound and stuff like that. But when I heard the melodies and stuff, and I heard him trying to change it up a little bit, I just couldn't lock in with it. And trust me, I didn't skip any songs. I actually played them out to hear him. And I just don't think that Ian is ready for that lane yet. It was a little too early to go into that, especially when you already got hype. It didn't make sense to just go into that 2093 sound or even change it up to where you start using tons of different melodies and singing and stuff. It just didn't sound right. It really wasn't a big point of me playing a lot of songs that were on here because I could just go play Yeet. And I don't even like hearing it from Yeet for real, but at least his sound is somewhat polished. But I'm not gonna lie, I heard that song with him and Sosa, and that was actually decent. I really didn't like the chorus, but I did like his verse, especially when Sosa came on. That was hard too. But overall, if you compare this to his last project, and I'm actually very curious to see how y'all feel about Ian's album, because that's just how I feel. I know a lot of people are gonna say, oh, dude, he's hate, but at least I listen to every song. And it's another thing I gotta say. I think a lot of y'all need to apologize to Yeet, because I'm seeing a lot of people change up now. Everybody wanna say Yeet is back and stuff like that. And I think we can stop with this whole Ian and Yeet comparison, because they're just not the same people. And this is why I be saying that we should-
They're not the same, not in a bad way. They're just not the same in terms of like how they sound. Cause I don't see it. I don't hear it. I don't see it. I can't imagine it. I don't understand how the fuck. That's truly fucking, I truly, I've played this fucking album, this Ian album every day since it came out. So that's like a week. I played this shit every single fucking day and I've tried to hear and listen and truly dig deep and see and hear what y'all are hearing. I cannot fucking hear. I'm dead fucking dead ass, bro. So, I don't know, bro.
And Ian,
you know,
I've been seeing.
I don't understand. Like, why is this even happening, bro? Can we not just listen to two artists? You know what I mean? Because.
but they're just not the same people. And this is why I be saying that we shouldn't even be comparing Ian and Yeet. I've been seeing tweets where people are talking about Ian streams, or they're saying that Yeet is streaming more than Ian. Why are we even comparing? We all know that Yeet is...
That's what I've been saying. Why are we trying to compare streams? Like, that fucking matters. I said that in the fucking last controversy video, bro. Why are we trying to compare streams? Like, that matters at all. Like, streams does not determine the whole fucking sound of the project. Stop fucking making streams determine how the whole album sounds. If it doesn't sound, if it doesn't sell under 200k, oh, the album's dog shit. No, bro. That's not what the fuck that means. I wish niggas would stop basing their fucking opinion on music on streams, bro. Like, that just doesn't need to happen anymore. I don't know why the fuck... I don't know why in 2024 that's still happening, but...
And that Yeet is streaming more than Ian. Why are we even comparing them? We all know that Yeet is the bigger artist. And you know, Ian is doing his own thing. He's on the rise, too.
But respectfully.
I do see a lot of y'all gassing Ian to make it seem like he's bigger than what he is. And there's... He's on the rise too, but I do see a lot of y'all gassing Ian to make it seem like he's bigger than what he is. And there's tons of people that actually think that Ian is just better than Yeet. Like, I don't know why y'all think that.
I don't think Ian is better than Yeet. I don't think Yeet is better than Ian. I think they're two separate artists. I'm not willing to say who's better. I'm not willing to compare them. I'm just listening to two fucking people, and I don't know why we're still trying to say who's better. You know what I mean? I don't know why the main focus right now is Yeet and Ian. So that's my. I'm not even gonna try and dig into the whole like the whole Ian and Yeet comparisons no more. I'm like, I haven't from jump, but it's like, bro, I'm just not like, it's two artists, bro. Can we just listen to them?
Whatever. Like, for example, I seen somebody agree with me in the comments. They talking about some, yo, why do you keep comparing someone in the mainstream to someone who's just popping? Laughing emoji. Then someone else said, are you dumb? These artists are not even comparable levels sales-wise, and he definitely got more streams than YouTube views. And I'm seeing people actually trying to make it seem like Ian and Yeet are actually beefing, because there were a few times where I was listening to the album and I was like, yo, Yeet gotta be talking about somebody, right? And that somebody could be Ian, possibly. But one of them that stood out the most is when Yeet said, yeah, go ahead, be a meme. They gonna forget about you. Yeah, I'm the real King Yeet. But like I said, there was a few times where he kind of was talking this stuff and you thought he was talking about somebody specifically. But honestly, we don't know if they're actually beefing or not. Who knows? But these are just my first thoughts. I might go back and try to listen to that Ian project again. But y'all let me know how y'all feel about the album when y'all heard it. And I've been now going for a few...
Nigga, now you won't. That's what we're talking about. It's the main comparison. I don't even remember what Dirk sounds like on that track, so I can't even give my opinion on that, but that whole Dirk track's crazy. I don't remember what it sounds like to even give my opinion on the Dirk track. The Kodak track has to grow on me. I feel like that was it kind of sounded raspy is the only thing I really remember about it. Think he's trying to compete with anybody. This is not even valid either, because bro. Okay, just literally glazing Yeet at the point, like, you're not even making any valid points. It's not even like I'm trying to gas in or hate Yeet or fucking... God, great. I never saw this either. It's not even like I'm trying to gas or throw anybody under the fucking bus. Like, I've been a fan of Yeet. I'm a fan of Ian. I've been a fan of Ian since fucking Magic Johnson. And even Figure It Out. So, the main thing I don't get is why the comparisons exist. Like, niggas isn't gonna forget about the comparisons. Niggas is just gonna let artists be artists, and I hope that happens. Cause it's not even worth... Okay, see, this is like... like, it's not even worth trying to give your time and feed your energy into trying to compare two separate artists who really don't even sound the same realistically. But I mean, you know, niggas is gonna say I'm glazing Ian, so I'm just gonna stop talking and end the fucking video. Literally, if I put this up on TikTok and I state my valid opinion that matters, and everybody's saying, like, literally everybody's just trying to be sheeps and say that Ian sounds like he, when he literally fucking doesn't, and everybody's gonna try and say that I'm glazing Ian and trying to downplay Yi. So I guess think whatever the fuck you want. Thank y'all for watching. Shout out Ian and Yi. I hope they're not beefing, because that would truly be sad. I'm not gonna lie. And even if they are, bro, they're artists at the end of the day. Like, I don't know why we're trying to make it seem like, you know, I don't know why we're trying to, like, still compare niggas when it's not even that deep. It's like, I don't get it. But shout out you and shout out you.